Hi everybody, it's Steve here and welcome to another video. Today I'm actually going to be doing a tarot card pull for inner peace. What is awesome about this is I set an intention before I started this video of pulling this card for anyone watching this video right now or in the future. So if you're here, it means that this is something that you need to know for your inner peace. So the universe brought you here, it pulled you here, and you're meant to be here. So that's what's so cool about all of this. And when I did this, I actually got really present with my tarot deck. And the single card that I pulled for all of us is the reversed King of Pentacles. So this is what that card looks like in my deck. It says leader, but it's the same thing. In most decks, it's called the king. So it is the reverse, which means, see, this is if it was upright, but because I pulled it upside down, it's the reversed King of Pentacles. And the Suit of Pentacles has to do with the material world. So the key words involved with this card are financially inept, obsessed with wealth and status, and stubborn. I would just encourage you that when you heard that, if anything like hit with you, that's what you need to know. And throughout the whole reading that I'm doing, like if there's things that like, you're like, yes, that feels right to me, like that's what I need to know, that's what you need to know. And it's different for everybody, right? Like I'm gonna get something different out of it than you are. So that's what's also really awesome about tarot is it's flexible and it's like presents to us exactly what we as an individual need to take from this. I'm going to get more into what this card could potentially mean for us in regards to inner peace. So the first meaning that it could have is that it's asking you actually to look at your relationship with money and wealth. And is it a healthy relationship? Is it in balance? Or is it actually like consuming you and taking over, right? So it's asking like, what are your priorities here? Is money and accumulating wealth your top priority? It's asking you to take a step back and kind of reassess your life and your priorities, because not that money is bad in any way, but when it takes the top spot priority in our life, it doesn't really allow space for anything else. And we can let that desire for more and more and more consume us. So it's something to watch out for in regards to your inner peace. It also could mean that maybe you're not managing your money or wealth very wisely. So you might be attracting the money, but then you can't seem to like hold on to it for some reason. It's like you're spending it or it's somehow like going out the door. And so one thing we can look at is our relationship with money. So just like you have a relationship with friends and your family, you also have a relationship with money because money is an energy. So what are the things that you say to money? Like, is it like, I need more, you're not enough? You know, we got to watch those types of things and become aware of what the things we actually are saying to our money, because just like with everything else in our life, it's a relationship. And so we need to treat it with love and respect. Another way that this card could be showing something to us is that it could actually represent a person. So it's a king, right? It's a King of Pentacles. So it could actually represent a person in your life. It could represent you. And basically the characteristics of this person is stubborn and rigid in approach. Basically, it's asking us to look at our life. How is this showing up in our life, right? For ourselves, like, are you feeling stuck in a rut and like life is just feeling kind of predictable and dull and you're not quite energized by life right now? Well, it's asking you to take a look at that and, are you giving yourself permission to find new opportunities or broaden your perspective on things that you could do or like ways that you could have more fun in life, right? Like less rigidity, more flexibility, more fun, more spontaneity. Like how can you bring that into your life, right? And that might mean you, it could mean a person in your life too. So if it is a person in your life that is disturbing your inner peace? Like, how can you bridge that conversation with that person of like, hey, what if we tried this thing, or would you be up for doing this thing differently today? You know, these are ways that this reverse King of Pentacles card might be affecting your inner peace. So again, like whatever really like connected with you, that's what you need to know from this reading. If you enjoyed this reading, I'm thinking about doing more of these. So let me know how you enjoyed this in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you and know what kind of takeaways did you get from it? Like, were there any like ahas? Yes, that is definitely hitting home for me. I'd love for you to share it in the comments to hear from you. And thank you so much for being here, for taking the time to watch this video. I hope that you found it helpful. And as always, I would encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you enjoyed this. Peace and highest vibes, and I'll see you next time. Take care.